morning or not listening. Today we are going to see the topic of Ad-Rapid Control. Ad-Rapid Control is a service provided by Globe Facing Control, who direct ad traffic on the Globe and through controlled hashes, and can provide advisory service to the ad traffic in non-controlled hashes. The primary purpose of the ADC worldwide is to prevent collision between the ad traffic and organizes and expedite the flow of ad traffic and provide information and other support to the pirates. In some countries, ADC provides security or differential role of operated by the military. To prevent the collision, ADC avoids traffic suppression rules, which ensure each aircraft maintains a minimum amount of empty space around its all types. Many aircraft also have collision avoidance systems, which provide additional safety by warning pilot when other aircraft get too close. In many countries, ADC provides service to all private, military, and commercial aircraft operating with its airspace, depending on the type of pilot and the classes of airspace. ADC may issue instructions that pilot and crew are required to obey or advisory that pilot may under distinct instruction. The pilot in the command is the final authority for the safe operation of the aircraft and may in emergency situations. Diving from ADC instruction to the excellent required to maintain safe operation of the aircraft. ADC is the tallest building in the airport. Here, ADC controls all the airport controls over the system. The primary method of controlling the immediate airport environment is visual observation from the airport control tower. The tower is a tall window structure located on the airport floor. Air traffic controls are responsible for the separation and the efficient movement of the aircraft and reduce operating of the taxis and runways of the airport. An aircraft with an air near to the airport generally 5 to 10 nautical miles depending on the airport procedures. Surveillance displays are also available to control a large airport to assist with controlling air traffic control. Controllers may use the radar systems called secondary surveillance radars for airport traffic approaching and then departure. These displays, include a map of the area, the position of various aircraft, and data type that includes position in address radar condition. The tower controls may also use surface movement radar. Surface movement guidance and controlling systems or advisor to the control traffic on the manoeuvring area. The area of responsibility for power controller fall into the three general operational disciplines: local control or air control, ground control, flight control, clearance, delivery. Other categories such as airport control or ground movement flights may exist to enable extremely busiest airports, while each tower may have unique airport specific such as multiple types of controllers and major or complex airport bits multiple airports. The following provide a general concept of the declaration of responsibilities within the tower environment. Ground control. Ground control is responsible for the airport movement area as well as area of use to the airlines or other. This generally includes all taxiways, principal runways, boarding areas of some other transitional airports, airports, or intersection where aircraft arrive. Having varied the runway on departing gate. Some busy airport have surface movement radar to descend to display aircraft and vehicles on the ground. These are used by the ground control as an additional tool to control ground traffic. exist at all times. The alcatrol detects any unsafe condition. A landing aircraft may be inspected, drone, and be resequenced into the landing aircraft. Within the tower, a high display communication process between air control and the ground control is an absolute necessity. Air control must ensure that the ground control is aware of any operation that will impact the accident and work with the approach level controls to create gaps in the arrival and traffic to allow taxiing traffic to approach the runway and allow departing aircraft to take off. Ground control need to keep the air controller aware that traffic flow towards the runway in order to maximize runway utilization through effective output space. Next, flight data clearance delivery we are going to see. Clearance delivery is the question that issues route clearance to the aircraft, typically for the commercial taxi. These clearance contain details of the route that the aircraft expected to fly after departure, clearance delivery on the busy or that busiest aircraft.